I'm not paranoid, I'm just being smart. Good morning from Whistler, Canada. Today, me and my sister, who maybe you can see, getting the shot here. See? We're driving up to a town called Lillooet. That's today's plan. It's about 2 hours and 20 minutes if you drive there direct. But we're not driving direct, we're taking a lot of side roads and stopping along the way to see what we can see. It's still sunny and warm. It's supposed to be very, very warm today, up in the upper 80s Fahrenheit.
What? Bus.
Plane?
Plane, look at the plane.
Oh yeah, well there's a plane. I'll show you the plane.
It's gonna land on the water too.
It's gonna land on the water too. Already cool stuff happening. On today's adventure, the Canadian road trip plunges further into the wild regions of southern British Columbia. The sea-to-sky highway north of Whistler is at times rural in the community barn. Of course, quaint, genuinely perfect. Dramatic, oh, we can see the whole road from here. Remote, there's hardly anything around. And downright frightening. And apparently we're also in grizzly bear country. A lot can happen in this part of Canada, and it did as we followed the winding highway to the dusty outpost of Lillooet. And all of it was pretty unexpected and revealing. And did I mention frightening?
Good.
Is it landing on the water?
It's about. It's not yet.
Well, already amazing things happening on this drive. And it's hard to kind of capture. We're on Highway 99, the Sea to Sky Highway, up to Lillooet. If you take nothing else from this clip, that's what's happening today. So stop looking at me, the adventure is this way. Whoa! Minutes later, just driving down the road. I know it's quite loud. If the motorcycles stop going by, you will hear the roar of this river. On this highway, Highway 99, it's not always easy to find a place to turn around. Sometimes you have to go a ways away and somehow make a U-turn somewhere. But this one was worth it. We had to go way back and way down and all this stuff. But we made it because look at the color of the water, the glacial silt in this river, and the roar of the water over the rocks. And Cricky taking pictures. Inspiring, I say. Found a little turnoff to get right down to the water's edge. I should go touch the water to anoint the trip, you know? Let's go touch the water. Wow, that's really cold. We'll be right back. I mean, we keep seeing these train tracks, and I've not seen a single train. I don't know how often they're used by trains. I think they are. It's like one a day or something. It's just from a video taken point of view, it would be perfect. But I haven't seen one yet. But I hope so. I hope so. Hopefully on this trip we'll see a train moving on tracks in a scenic place. Wow. Pulled over to look at this kind of lake pond thingy here. Which looks pretty cool, but as I was pulling over, I noticed there is a wooden walkway through it. Perfection. Brief stop in Pemberton, British Columbia. A lovely little town. We're parked by the community barn, and we're just gonna walk around town a little bit. When you come to Pemberton, you get a free hat. All right, we got very simple lunch fixins from the supermarket, and we're going to eat perhaps in the car. It's very hot today. I mean, it's getting hotter. What is it now, about 82?
83, 84.
And we're gonna leave Pemberton, which has been very lovely and cute and nice, and maybe eat in the car somewhere on the road. A small lunch, but Pemberton is worth the visit. What a setting. I see your car elevator and I raise you snowmobile elevator. And when I say eat in the car, turns out I mean eat in the community barn. Of course, we've got table water crackers, hummus, original, and organic puree, puree biologique. So, simple dinner, lunch, breakfast, whatever this is, here in Pemberton, wouldn't you say?
Yes.
It's hot. We don't care to be hot in the summertime in Canada. We think we should be cooler. Well, so much for continuity. Okay, we left Pemberton. Is that where we ate? Yeah.
Yep.
All these little town names are confusing me. So we ate at the public community barn in Pemberton, and we're still on Highway 99, but as soon as we left there, it got up way up into the mountains. The road is very steep and very, very windy, and it's super wilderness. It's the Canada you think of when you think of not the Rockies, but like all the forest and stuff. It's a fun drive, and there's hardly anything around except huge slopes and trees and much bigger patches of snow. It's very, very exciting. And apparently we're also in grizzly bear country. Now we saw really cool horses earlier, some kind of apparently wild horses or loose horses or something, just wandering down the side of the road. But if we see any grizzly bears, I hope they're not while I'm outside the car, but I'm keeping my eyes peeled. Grizzly bear and caribou and black bear and more horses. Wanted to get out and show you, maybe try to get some better video of some of the snow. It's not bigger snow fields, it's just that we're closer to them. Been seeing this lake coming up on the GPS screen, and we actually got here. I mean, there may be something as good on earth as this, but there's nothing better on earth than this scene right here. genuinely perfect. Except for we are constantly, constantly being attacked by grizzly bears. Probably. I mean, I haven't seen any yet, but I know they're all out there watching. They're all watching us go by. They know where we are. I'm not paranoid. I'm just being smart. Here's a view from the end of the lake looking back. It's all right, I guess. Another cool bridge, a little pedestrian bridge. Do I trust it? I'm sure it's fine. There's no sign that says, do not enter. I'm a trusting soul. Woo. Yeah. Got up to see the big rock, but I want to see what's over this, the edge of this ledge here. Whoa! That's blood sugar's a little bit low. Having a Canadian cookie, a celebration cookie, and in a great place. If I was going to be low somewhere, I'd want to be low here. We're coming kind of out of the mountain, so we've had some like steep downgrades of 13%, which is very, very steep on some of these hills or whatever, roads. This one, the next 7 kilometers, apparently is such an ordeal that they got these many more signs and this big one here explaining the exact nature of what's coming for the next 7 kilometers. It's 13%, which is extremely steep. Then it gets to 11%, then 10%, all very steep. says, please check your brakes. It's not really a big deal for this car. This car can handle it, but I'm very impressed. I'm very excited about the next 7 kilometers. Looks like it's going to be downhill and very curvy and kind of distracting with all these distracting views. I can't really look at the views too much because I'm trying to drive on these curvy roads. I hope the dash cam footage is nice on the way down because that's how I'm really going to enjoy the views here. But anyway, here they are for you to enjoy now. T1D Wanderer, guaranteed rugged. Okay, back in the car, there might be bears. We are here, we're technically in Lillooet, although we're still way in the rural parts, I think. But we're getting closer to the town of Lillooet, or whatever it is. Okay, it's about 5 p.m., 93 degrees Fahrenheit, and we are outside of Lillooet and we're hiking a trail to the Seton Lake lookout? Seton. And it's somewhere down this trail, we think. We're not sure if we can handle some of the high cliff parts, but we're gonna go as far as we can and see what happens. And yes, the first thing we saw when we started hiking was someone had discarded a packaging for like a bear repellent. What was that?
It could have been like a loud alarm thing.
A loud alarm thing, which I'm going to use right now so the bears are scared away before we even get there. I'm nervous about the bears. Anyway, it looks nice so far, and it's shaded. So there's view one of Seton Lake. Not the shoes for this, is it? It's like right on the edge of possible for these shoes. I was like, it's bear poo, but it's just that. Well, he really had to go. Is what? Yes, it's leveled out finally. I am not wearing the shoes for this, but we made it to the top, but now we're gonna go over here. Okay, here is the end, the final little climb to the apex. It's a little bit steep and there's a precipice. So I'm gonna go up, she's gonna stay here, and I'm gonna try to be careful. It's something. I made it to the top here. It's a great view. There's this horse, what do you call it? Horse hair, shoe bend. Anyway, I made it and look who else made it. No problem. Turns out there was a back way that wasn't as scary as climbing up like the sheer drop off, which is only about 30 feet, but still you don't want to fall off it. So here it is. So you get more of the road and less of the trees over here. Oh, we can see the whole road from here. Ah, very cool. This is one of those things that it's sort of overdone. Like anybody who's in this area will kind of do this. And if you go on the internet, there's like millions of pictures of it and stuff. But all the guides say it's 100% worth it. Just do it, just do it. And it's true. It doesn't matter that it's like super duper overdone or whatever, popular. You need to come here and do this. And if you can't, at least enjoy this view of it. All right, now to go back down. Quite exhilarating. And the heat is not bad because it's shady. It's all right, there's actually rocks to hold on to here. You can kind of scramble down like on all fours on your back of your hands. Well, here's the thumbnail. I have foolishly elected to go the hard way down.
What? You're not going to go that way?
Whew. Okay, this is the trek down, which is sort of the easy part, but really it isn't, because it's kind of steep and slippery with dusty and little pebbles, and I'm wearing shoes that were never meant for this, and they're like a year old. Wow. So far, so good. And we're here at the fabulous Reynolds Hotel in Lillooet, right in the center of town, the only place to stay. A very, very rustic kind of almost scenic building in and of itself. So anyway, great drive today. This is a really nice hotel room. Again, we got adjacent rooms. What we're gonna do now is go find dinner somewhere. The hotel has its own restaurant, which I would have chosen, but they close at 6 and we checked in at like 5:50, so can't go there. We're gonna find dinner around somewhere around town and then maybe drive around a little bit, kind of in and outside of town, and take a look at the town and also maybe find something to photograph when the sun is going down later tonight. And that will be in the extended version of the video. So in this video here now, thank you very much for driving with us, with me, up from Whistler to here in Lillooet. Looks like a great place. And tomorrow, another adventure. So, thanks, Canada. See you next time. This video continues in the extended version. See the whole thing, plus past and future extended videos without ads, and get other special perks via my Patreon page by pledging support for my work exploring unusual and lesser-known destinations. Special thanks this week to Calvin Ferreira, Darcy Otranto, David Richley, Jacob Fats, Lever Wong, Matt Kane, Michael Fedor, Nathaniel Holland, Omeyer, Ray Nichols, Samantha, and Will Phillips. You can also sign up for my free weekly email newsletter, which features behind-the-scenes info and early links to videos before they're public. Links to both are in the video description, and thanks for wandering around with me.